APIs are everywhere. They power the apps we use, from social media to banking. But here's the big question. How do APIs know that the request is coming from the right person, app, or system? The answer lies in API authentication methods. In this video, I'm going to walk you through all the major API authentication methods. Starting from the simplest ones, like API keys, all the way to advanced enterprise-grade methods like Mutual TLS and SAML. But first, some basics. Authentication means proving who you are. Authorization means what you can do. And most modern APIs use both. Also, we're assuming that HTTPS is being used everywhere, as sending any credentials over plain HTTP is a hard no. By the end, you'll know not just what they are, but when and why to use them. With that in mind, let's get started. Let's begin with the most common one, that is API keys. An API key is just a long string of characters that identifies the calling app. You send it with every request, usually in the headers or query string. For example, if you're using Google Maps API, you'll often see something like this in the URL. It's simple and widely supported, but also weak in terms of security. That is, if someone gets hold of your key, they can use your API. For better understanding, think of it like a house key. If copied, anyone can get in. So API keys are best for simple apps, or low-risk data, and not for protecting sensitive information. Next up is basic authentication. Here you send your username and password with every request encoded in Base64. It looks something like this. This method is also super easy to implement, but at the same time also very risky. If in case you're not using it on HTTPS, it's like shouting your password across the room. But even if you do implement it with HTTPS protocol, constantly reusing the same credentials isn't ideal as well. So today, it's mostly used for testing or authenticating simple internal systems. Now let's move to bearer tokens. A bearer token is simply a string that proves the holder has access. Whoever presents it or bears it can reach the resource. You send it in the header like this. If the token is valid, the API grants access. These tokens don't have to follow a specific format, as they can be any string issued by the server. One very common implementation of this type is the JWT, or JSON Web Token. A JWT is a structured, self-contained token format. It encodes claims such as user ID, roles, and an expiration time inside a JSON object. Because it's digitally signed, the server can verify the contents without a database lookup as well. For example, a JWT might say, user123 has admin role, valid until 5 p.m. This makes the JWT as very popular for modern REST APIs, OAuth 2 flows, and single sign-on apps. The drawback is that once issued, revoking them is difficult. That's why you usually rely on short lifetimes and refresh strategies. So in summary, all JWTs can be used as bearer tokens, but not all bearer tokens are JWTs. Next, we have OAuth 2.0, which is the most common standard you'll see today. If you've ever clicked sign in with Google or log in with Facebook on any website, that's OAuth working in the background. Here's the simple idea. You give an app permission to do certain things on your behalf. The app then receives an access token, and often a refresh token to keep getting new access without asking you again. But the real power of OAuth is in scopes. A scope decides what the app can do. Maybe it can read your emails but not send them, or see your calendar but not delete it. That fine-grained control is why OAuth is the go-to choice for apps that connect to user accounts. Although it requires more setup than keys or tokens, it's essential for most modern age integrations. Now let's talk about Hmac, or hash-based message authentication code. Here, instead of sending just a token, the client generates a signature using a secret key in the request details, like the URL and timestamp. The server recalculates the signature, and if they match, the request is considered valid. Such a process also ensures that the request wasn't tampered with. You'll see Hmac used in many financial APIs, like payment gateways or crypto exchanges, because it provides strong integrity. Even if someone intercepts the request, they can't reuse it without knowing the secret key. For very high security, we have Mutual TLS, also called mTLS. Normally, TLS certificates secure the server, but with mTLS, both the client and the server present certificates to each other. This way, both sides are verified. Think of it as showing both, your ID and the other person showing theirs before starting a conversation. It's extremely secure, but requires complex certificate management. This method is widely accepted in banking, healthcare, and enterprise APIs, where trust is everything. One older method is Digest Authentication, wherein, instead of sending your password directly, it uses a challenge response mechanism with hashing. The server sends a unique challenge, often including a random word, and the client responds with a hashed version that combines the password and that word. This avoids exposing the password directly and makes replay attacks harder. But in practice, it's mostly outdated and replaced by better methods such as bearer tokens or OAuth. Still, you might run into it with older systems, especially in legacy enterprise environments, or older web services, so it's good to know it exists. Another option some systems use is client certificates, wherein, instead of passwords or tokens, each client has a digital certificate installed. When connecting, the server checks that certificate to confirm the client's identity. This provides strong cryptographic trust, but on the downside, managing and distributing certificates can be complicated. You'll find this approach in enterprise or highly secure environments, where controlling every client device is crucial. Then there's SAML, or Security Assertion Markup Language. This one is XML-based and is huge in large enterprises. It's mainly used for single sign-on, which means employees can log in once, and then access many apps and systems without having to re-enter their credentials each time. This makes it very convenient for large organizations that manage dozens of internal tools. SAML works by passing authentication assertions from an identity provider, like a company's central login system, to the services that need them. While SAML isn't common for public APIs, it plays a big role in enterprise integrations, corporate intranets, and B2B connections, where centralized identity management is critical. Although it's more verbose and harder to set up than newer standards like OpenID Connect, it remains a trusted and widely deployed solution in many enterprises, even in this age. Lastly, there are some honorable mentions, including OpenID Connect, or OIDC, which builds on OAuth 2.0 but adds identity verification to it, so that not only is access granted, but the system can also confirm who the user is. Then there are enterprise-only methods, like Kerberos, which uses tickets for secure identity exchange within corporate networks, or LDAP, which is short for Lightweight Directory Access Protocol, and is commonly used for centralized directory services and authentication in organizations. It acts as a phone book for systems, storing user accounts and credentials in one place so multiple applications can rely on the same source of truth for login. There are also more experimental approaches like Hawk Authentication, which is a token-based scheme with request signing. These last few methods are far less common in public APIs, but they exist in specialized environments, where tighter integration with enterprise systems or additional cryptographic safeguards are required. So, to recap, API keys and basic authentication are simple to implement but weak. Bearer tokens and JWT are modern, stateless, and very widely used. OAuth 2.0 is flexible and powerful, with scopes and refresh tokens for fine-grained access. Hmac and mTLS offer strong cryptographic protection, which is best suited for finance, healthcare, and enterprise systems. Digest, Client Certificates, SAML. These are mostly legacy or enterprise-specific methods that you may still encounter in specialized environments. Other methods like OIDC, Kerberos, LDAP, Hawk are less common in public APIs but important in enterprise or specialized contexts. In all, choosing the right method depends on your use case, whether you value simplicity, ease of scaling, or strict enterprise-grade security. For example, a small side project might get by with just API keys, while a growing SaaS platform could benefit from OAuth and JWT for more flexibility. On the other hand, if you're in a heavily regulated industry, such as finance or healthcare, options like HMAC, MTLS, or even SAML may be necessary to meet compliance requirements. Ultimately, the goal is to balance security, convenience, and maintainability so the system remains both safe and easy to use. That's it. All major API authentication methods summarized in this short video. If you found this helpful, don't forget to like the video, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.